Sai Ram. Thanks to Swami for having made this session, which is going to cover the details of the divine trip to Delhi and Simla. Well, my friends, I am very fortunate to have been selected and accompanied Bhagawan during this trip. In fact, for the last couple of days, people have been speaking of the divine trip. And some say that they give their own date. Some say he may go here, he may not go some other place. Some also started giving their own names of the people that accompany Swami. Everything is rather in the air. Nothing is finalized. Just around 6th April, things have been finalized. We have come to know who is accompanying and the places of visit. Well, it is very well made clear that Swami would start here on 9th April, that he would go to Delhi and spend there for a couple of days and then may go to Simla and spend for a day or two and finally return. And also the boys who are selected also have come to know of their inclusion in the divine trip. My friends, the fascinating thing is this. Bhagawan visited Delhi 11 years ago for the inauguration of Sri Sathya Sai International Stadium in Delhi. Sri Sathya Sai International Center in Delhi has so many activities to its credit. Sri Sathya Sai International Center is managed by experts like General Chibba, the Army General, like Maharaja Rasagotra of Indian Foreign Service, past governors, lieutenant governors, top people manage Sri Sathya Sai International Center in Delhi. Bhagawan inaugurated 11 years ago. Therefore, people in Delhi have been eager, have been waiting for him all these years. Now you can understand how anxious they are to have him in their midst. Well, on 9th of April, boys started moving in cars. Other elders selected also started moving in their respective cars to Sri Sathya Sai Airport, located in Prashanti Nilayam. All cars are speeding up. You know the time? The time of departure is 2:30 in the afternoon. And for information, you may know the summer is very, very extraordinarily severe this year. Scorching sun, severe heat, unbearable. Well, you can't walk because of the heat. But strangely enough, all devotees started lining up on either side of the road at the airport to greet Bhagawan, to cheer him up and to bid him farewell at the airport. I saw some standing on mountains and water tanks. I saw some climbing the trees to have a glimpse of Bhagawan. Nowhere it would ever take place in severe summer. And Swami reached the airport and he got into the plane, and that is Kingfisher. Kingfisher, a chartered flight from Puttaparthi to Delhi. The group comprises 18 students and 10 elders. And all of us are seated comfortably in the flight. And now begins the captain, the chief pilot, and members of the crew started lining up to take Padanamaskar from Swami. They touched his feet. The pilot, the co-pilot, the members of the crew cabin, they all touched his feet. And the pilot took his permissions, Bhagawan, shall we fly now? After receiving his blessings, he has gone into the cockpit to begin the flight. Here I want to tell you a very interesting thing. The captain or the chief pilot of the Kingfisher flight that morning happened to be a former Balavikas student in Kanpur. This pilot today was the Balavikas child long back. You can estimate his joy now. Now is the pilot of the aircraft in which Bhagawan is seated. His joy knew no bounds. He was ecstatic, jumping in joy. He started moving. And we reached there in Delhi, around 4:45 in the evening, Indira Gandhi Airport, New Delhi. And all are busy. First Bhagawan left, and then we all followed him. There at the airport, it was the Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh, Rosaya, who greeted him, received him, and touched his feet, welcoming to the capital of the nation, the New Delhi. That's how it started, our journey, our trip in New Delhi. We drove straight to that Sri Sathya Sai International Center in New Delhi. How is that international center? The international center in New Delhi is three-storied building, and it is brick in its color, like bricks that we use, rather reddish in its color. From a distance you find as if the stones are packed like old buildings, like monumental buildings. It has got the architectural beauty. The color is reddish in its color, like Red Fort of India, there in Delhi, red in its color. Like the Parliament building, it has got that color, a three-storied building. And then there is basement where bhajans take place every day, necessarily on Thursdays and Sundays, attended by 4,000 to 5,000 people, closely packed. And then the first floor has got corridors all around, and there's a lift, and then it will take you to the second floor where there are guest rooms, and third floor exclusively for Bhagawan. All guest rooms are well furnished and very, very comfortable. And third floor is for Swami. lift is there to facilitate our movement.